Hey everyone, I am here with Ramiro again to cover some Azure AD App Proxy videos. If you haven't watched it already, please go and watch the App Proxy Fundamentals video where Ramiro walks you through the components. In this video, we're going to cover an on-premises application that uses SAML for authentication. To set the stage, we have Kim who will access Tableau Server. It sits on Corp Network and uses SAML authentication. Tableau Server has already been onboarded with Azure AD App Proxy for pre-authentication, which is covered more in the in-depth video that Ramiro covered on fundamentals. Ramiro, do you want to give a quick summary here about pre-authentication?
Sure. When App Proxy is involved, users will be asked to authenticate before even try to get to on-premises so that only authenticated traffic goes through. To be clear, if an app is already in the public internet and it's already available, for example, a SaaS app, we definitely recommend integrating the app with Azure AD directly. But in this scenario with Tableau Server, we're talking about an instance that is on-premises. So App Proxy needs to be in place to provide that remote access for the users.
Great. Thanks, Ramiro. So let's walk through the flow now using the diagram so it's easier to visualize how this all comes together. In step one, Kim goes to the same URL that she had bookmarked for Tableau Server, even before App Proxy was involved. Under the covers, DNS is pointed to the App Proxy cloud service. Using the same internal and external URL is considered best practice since it avoids translation problems. Users don't have to remember two separate URLs depending on where they're coming from, like inside or outside the corp network. Even better, if you don't want to have your users remember any URLs, you can have them use MyApps in the MyApps portal. So in step two, the App Proxy Cloud Service uses the original URL of the HTTP request to check the core store to find the app configuration to know what to do for the rest of the flow. Once it has this information, the App Proxy Cloud Service redirects Kim to Azure AD for pre-authentication. This is in step three. Here, Auth Services implements the OpenID Connect protocol for handling authentication. In step four, Authentication Services validates Kim's credentials, conditional access is evaluated, and any policies or controls that are in place, they're applied to that user. In step five, the Authentication Services issues Kim a token scoped specifically to App Proxy. And after that, this fulfills the pre-authentication process. Since the flows are a bit noisy, we're going to clear the steps for pre-authentication and continue with the rest of the flow. So now that App Proxy has the token, it will forward an HTTP request to Tableau Server in step six. In this example, Tableau Server is a SAML app. And since there is no SAML token at play yet, the service sends a SAML request back in step seven. The App Proxy connectors pick up the request, which is directed back through the App Proxy cloud service. The App Proxy in turn renders the content back to Kim. The browser in Kim's machine will interpret the redirect and send it to Azure AD. Since Kim was already authenticated back in step four, there are already cookies in place, and so Kim is not going to be interrupted whatsoever.
Yeah, this is what we were mentioning before about user experience. Because the user was pre-authenticated to even get to on-premises, the user will not be disrupted again, and these cookies that Corissa was mentioning kick in. And that's despite the fact that we need a new token, which is SAML in this case. The configuration for SAML is the same regardless of whether the application is on-prem or is in the cloud. But in order to get the conversation started with the on-prem service, this pre-authentication step is done by application proxy.
Exactly. So now in step eight, Azure AD returns the SAML response and App Proxy forwards it back to Tableau Server via the connectors. In step nine, Tableau Server now has what it needs and it validates the SAML response. And now Kim is signed in successfully to Tableau Server. From this point onwards, the communication between Kim and Tableau Server is going through App Proxy seamlessly.
Okay, let's do a quick recap. First, even though SAML apps are configured to authenticate to Azure AD directly, it is still recommended to use pre-authentication to protect on-premises servers from malicious traffic patterns. Second, for SAML apps that follow the best practice that we just described, there are two requests at play. One, is a token to an app proxy for pre-authentication, and the second is to get a SAML token for the on-premises app itself. Even though there are two requests, then the user will not notice. App proxy provides the exact same authentication experience as if the user was signing to a SaaS application. If you want to know more about Azure AD Application Proxy, make sure that you check the other videos where we talk about the fundamentals of the app proxy service and how it's used in other scenarios. If you want to learn more about other topics in Azure Active Directory, make sure that you check the links on the box below for the entire architecture series. Thank you so much and see you next time.